Hi everyone, it's Reverend Laurie at Unity of Ocala with this week's Friday Love Notes. Yes, I'm changing the name from Wednesday Love Notes to Friday Love Notes because apparently Wednesday would not wait for me to get everything else done to do Love Notes. So I'm doing them on Friday. I hope you're okay with that because that's what's happening. So recently I've been talking to you about recreating our lives, writing new chapters, expanding our horizons, moving forward, especially all of those who are going through big changes in our lives, but all of us who have just come through this pandemic with all of the stuff that brought up, all of the confusion, the heartache, the challenges, the drama. It's time to look at where we want to be now, what we want to be now. And as I've shared with you, I'm creating these new compartments in my life, expanding things, because yes, I promised my husband I would make myself more available to life, to all things in life. And I'm looking at that as a way to become more of who I am. And I've realized that these compartments that I've explained to you with all of the parts of my life in them, and I need to add some more to that chest of drawers, I realize that some of those drawers are already there. I've already created them. I've just locked them up. You ever done that? For example, recently, a friend of mine reintroduced me to the classics of the 70s and 80s. Oh my gosh, I had forgotten some of that fabulous, incredible music that kind of raised me, that shaped me, that helped me fall in love and be happy and go deeper within myself and have great fun with my girlfriends, right? And I used to have in the little house I bought when I was in my early 20s, I had this little mobile home. And the first thing you see when you walked in the door was this big shelf with a stereo on it and all my albums. Remember those vinyls? Two rows of just albums. And that's the first thing I would do. I would put, and I had one of those that, you know, you could put like five of your favorite albums. It was actually a graduation present from my parents when I graduated from high school. And it went everywhere with me. Oh. And that's how I would do my evenings. I would blast that thing at speakers. I would blast that thing with the greatest music. And just that was heaven. That was heaven. That was heaven. And so I'm wondering, what other compartments have I kind of left closed or haven't visited in a while or need to rummage through and bring out those fabulous parts of me? That 22-year-old that wants to dance all by myself on the back porch and listen to these great songs or listen to some of these songs and cry or write something after I've listened to them. That's just one of the drawers I'm rediscovering. I can't wait to find the other drawers that are already in my chest of drawers that I just haven't looked at for a while. I'm encouraging you to do the same. Today's Lent message is about the grace of God. Oh, and I love this message because my God is not out there somewhere that's religious or deems who has a right life, depending on what they do or don't do. No, my God is in here, that force within me, that goodness in me, that growth in me, that love in me. It's in all things, everything. God is everywhere, everywhere present. The sap in the oak tree that takes a tiny acorn to this huge, massive, majestic creature. That sparkle in a baby's eye, that sweetness in all of life, the velvet on a rose, that's God, that energy, that force. So the grace comes from that, not somewhere out there that will save you when you're dealing with grief, in here, that will lift you out of your grief, right? That's unity. This month's favorite author for me, Cheryl Strayed. I've been reading you some of her work. She's just deep and profound. This is really important about the source. It ties in with your Lenten message. message, excuse me. And we're going to talk more about it on, oh no, I'm not going to be here on Sunday. We'll talk more about it next Sunday. Oh, listen to this. Take this in this week. You can't fake the core, the truth that lives within there. It will eventually win out. That core in us will eventually win out. It's a God we must obey, a force that brings us all inevitably to our knees. It asks eternally, will you do it later or will you do it now? See, I have a habit of sneaking off, doing things later. Don't want to face it right now. It's too much. I'm going to go pack my car and go away for a few months. Not going to do that. We have the capacity to redraw the lines between our powerlessness and our power. We're altered by what hurts us. But with love and consciousness, with intention and forgiveness, we can become whole again. Meditate on that and meditate on this. This is going to bring back some memories for you guys. Alexa, play Everything I Do.
Everything I Do It For You by Brian Adams.
Remember the song?
Amazon Music.
Oh my God. I heard this yesterday for the first time in 30 years and I cried. I cried. I've been on the dance floor with this song. And after I leave you, I'm going into a meditation and then I'm going to be dancing on my back porch by myself. My cat will probably join me. Oh. Can you hear it? I'm going to turn it up. Remember this?
Don't tell me it's not
so good. Oh, I love you. I'll see you on Sunday. No, I won't see you on Sunday. I'll see you next Friday. This is good. This is my song to all of you. I hope you turn Alexa onto this song today. It's a good one. See you later. Love you.